Hi guys, and welcome back to the Star Trek Online Agents of Yesterday playthrough. This episode is just going to be a level up sort of video. So last episode we leveled up to level 10. So I went and got myself a nice new ship, which we'll have a look in a minute. I also did a kind of nice formal outfit thing for Hannah to wear in episodes like this, and I also went and redid the bridge. So, oh no, thank you. So yeah, this is one of the variants for the Defiance type bridge, which I thought was quite cool, since the best way to get something out of this ship was an escort. So yeah, I'm just gonna leave the bridge interior and then go back to our space dock, and then we can carry on with this episode. Okay, so we're back at our space dock, and as you can see, I'm just in front of the shipyard area. As you saw in the last episode, that the blue line was from somewhere or another. I can't exactly remember where, because I've moved this character around a hell of a lot, swapping items and the like, but first bit was to go see the tailor, which we've gone and done. Also updated the uniform as well, which you'll see in the next episode. I want to point out now that this episode will not take up the one episode per week thing. This episode's just a bonus one, more than anything. So, following the nice shiny blue line to Philip Cray, who's the temple agent. Okay, welcome to the 25th century. Lieutenant Commander, we've been expecting you. Your new cover identity is in place, and Admiral Quinn is expecting you in the office behind me. Report to him for your orders. Remember, do not tell anyone about your status as a temporal agent. Your goal is to observe and correct, not to interfere. Okay, understood, and thanks. So, now let's go talk to Admiral Quinn. And he's on about the usual stuff, so I'll let you read that for a minute. Okay.
The Klingon Empire has been making aggressive moves in and around the neutral zone. Commander Wildman is spearheading Starfleet's efforts to contain the situation.
Okay, so go port to Deep Space K7. Okay. Melting Pot. I've already done Melting Pot on my main character, my engineer, Federation engineer. And yeah, so I'm going to leave that until it gets pushed around into a proper episode slot thing. Let's go quickly have a look. What's all this? Oh, it's all that other stuff. Yeah. All that's a lot of that is done off screen, things like that. So, the shipyard. This comes back to the new ship I picked up. Because we're level 10, and normally we'd start a brand new character would start off in the Miranda class. Excuse me. Okay, thank you. Which is this one. I do like the Miranda. Which was the came about in the Wrath of Khan, more so than anything, as the USS Reliance, which was kind of cool. You also get the Centaur, I'm not a great fan of that. The Shakir, it's alright. I used to play this game a hell of a lot before, like years ago, just as much as I do now, and I used to roll with that actually. the Saragossa is the new variant for the T6, as well as the actual Reliance, or the updated Reliance model for the Tier 6 version. As you saw, also rolled around with the original Constitution. And you got the Beta, which, meh. Truth be told, I actually prefer the original. Also have the NX-01, which is really nice to work with, and especially early game. Also got the Abirth as well, which is pretty cool. Also got the Steam Runner, which is actually quite nice as well. I do like using that. The new ship I've picked up is, I actually picked up all of them, and I pilfered all the cool consoles and the like out of it. So, go to that. I'm rolling around with the Escort. This is the Gladius skin. So, yeah, that's kind of cool. Got phaser dual cannons from the 23rd century sort of thing. Those are stock ones. That's not a stock one. Basically did all the bits and bobs. Impulse capacitance cell for that. Got the old armor plating one that we've seen in previous episodes. We also have the photonic displacement, which creates a carbon copy sort of thing when in, not take space, but the map, the normal map, which we'll go to in a moment. Also have the resonance cascade modulator, which is the Team Fortress console that you get on the Steam Runner. Okay, so after the resonance cascade modulator, I have the enhanced plasma manifold, which gives me a ton of bonuses for a small amount of time. This one you get off the actual escort refit. This one you get off the Nova, the science refit, the Lieutenant Commander one. That one you get off the Steam Runner, and you get that one from something. I've forgotten what the ship is you get it from, but yeah. So I'm just going to swap into the actual uniform, and then we can... Oh, got to speak to Admiral Quinn now, have I? Again. Alright, cool. So, going to tidy up here, and then we can go into orbit of ESD. So, one of the things I did pick up, which was really nice...
I see you chose a fine ship with a top-notch crew, one of Starfleet's best. I hope you're ready to get back out there. A situation has come to my attention, and I'd like you to look into it.
Alright, cool. Extra EXP.
I've received a report there is a Bolian freighter that is overdue arriving at Earth Space Dock. It may need assistance. Please talk to Malcolm Sissel in the shipyard. He will have more information about the missing vessel than I do.
Okay, cool. So, gotta find Nizor. And get a nice healthy amount of EXP and some cool stuff. Awesome. So that'll be for the next episode. So yeah, I'm going to swap into the uniform, and then we'll be back when we're in sector space or orbiting Earth Space Dock. Okay, so we're at Deep Space K7 in the neutral zone. So, yep, this is the ship. Nicely next to a very, very fast Excelsior. I'm not particularly sold on this skin, but I'm happy to use the Saber skin. If people want to see that, let me know, and I will happily change it. Also have one more surprise for everybody, which I thought was really, really cool. I have the actual holograms for the original series Bridge Crew, other than Kirk, but that's its own separate story that goes back years ago. So we got Sulu, we got Bones, Scotty, Chekhov, and we got Spock. We also have Janice Rand and Uhura as well. I haven't actually found particular use for these pair personally, but anyone else who's got them, please let me know. So, yeah, I was dead excited to get that pack. And, yeah, I put the 30th anniversary for Next Generation sash on and the thingy because of reasons. Whatever. So, yeah, let's go quickly do that. This, actually, while I'm here, in case if anyone hasn't seen this. Oh, that didn't work. what else? This one? He just kind of goes with it, like, super fast. And then the Team Fortress console. Just puts a bubble over around you and all your teammates. So, yeah. That's kind of cool. For 12 seconds is really nice. So, yeah, we're going to dock and then we'll run around and do all that. Okay, so just go report to Commander Wildman. If you recognise the name, then that is really cool. If not, then it is from Voyager, who is Commander Naomi Wildman. And she was the little kid who was on Voyager throughout, I think, the latter seasons, from about season 5 onwards-ish, something like that, 4 or 5. So, we're in the thick of it here, Lieutenant Commander. It's only a matter of time before the Klingon show up at our door, and they won't be here to play a Kadiscot. Well, that's the first time I'd actually pronounce that. Reports about Masters here on the station for situation reports on Klingon incursions into the neutral zone. So, it's fine. Welcome to Deep Space K7. Generally, yeah, speak to the Battlemasters and hope for the best. And those are the pair I've got to speak to. Awesome. It's a bit of a meh mission sort of thing, but it's free XP just for running around talking to two NCPs, which is like, it's alright. Not going to say no to that. We're in danger. I've been overrun. I need captains who aren't afraid to take action and stop the Klingons. This is War, Lieutenant Commander. It's bloody, it's nasty, and people are going to get hurt. It's what we do. We do the bad things so the good people survive. We get reports of skirmishes throughout the neutral zone. Starfleet needs skilled captains like you to keep the Klingons from pushing through and into Federation space. Yeah, why not? Where's the other bloke? That's not you.
Please remember that unaccompanied tribbles are an environmental hazard and will be confiscated by
security. Is this the other? Oh, yeah. The Sauron. Sauron. Cool, I have no orders for you at this time. The territory between Federation and Klingon space, being the neutral zone, is full of planets that have valuable resources, and we need to make sure we get hold of them. Cool. So, through there, so we can have a butchers at that LA state if people want to see it. But for now, we are done with K7 and 130 EXP just for talking to a couple of NCPs is perfectly fine by me. Cool, so that's it, and thank you for joining me on this episode, guys. Next episode will be Stranded in Space, which will come out at the same time this episode does. So, yeah. Thank you very much, guys, for watching, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.